But we're in line to do what they need, but they just haven't started doing it. That's about it. Anything else?
Mr. Chairman, would...
Yes.
Is it appropriate for public comment? Would you permit any public comments?
Sure, sure you can.
Okay. As Mr. Buck mentioned, there's a lot of us that are here because of the jail situation. We saw it in the paper. We understand that there was some informal discussion about the previous planning board meeting. And I have a few points that I just want to make, and I'll keep it brief. But I understand that the planning board is charged with considering what you think is in the best interest for the town of Chalkawinity. And I know that in deliberating your recommendation to the town board, you will carefully weigh all the advantages and disadvantages of this proposed regulation for accommodating a jail in the industrial park. But I wanted to mention four points, okay, briefly. First, the only advantage that I see, that most folks that I've talked to see, for allowing this jail in our jurisdiction is the possibility of increased sewer revenues. Now, there's people in this town hall that know a lot more about sewage capacity and sewer revenues than I do. But considering that, I believe that it would only be offset by having to obtain additional sewage capacity in the future. In other words, if we use this capacity for jail, the town is going to have to find, buy, build, should we need it for residential growth or new businesses or industry or a new school. We're going to have to go find this extra sewage capacity. The second thing I want to mention, and this is everybody, this is countywide, this is, and as a Chalkawinity resident, if we borrow as a county $20+ million, our taxes are going to go up. Most of us in this room are probably property owners. I don't know about you, but I feel like I'm paying enough right now. There's no urgent need to have a new jail. We can make do with what exists right now until school bond debt is retired before we take on another large project. Third, the jail may be a deterrent to the very thing that this park out here, Chalkawinity Industrial Park, was intended to do, and that was to attract industry. Keep in mind that what's being proposed is a very large complex, complete with an outside compound, all built to federal prison specifications to house 250 or more inmates. Bottom line, folks, there are better uses for that property. Industry's one of them. But if we're going to consider amending zoning regulations, then we need to consider doing it for something that would, without a doubt, benefit the town of Chalkawinity. And I submit to you that the highest, best use for that property is a new middle school in the town of Chalkawinity and surrounding community. We can do better than the jail. And so what I'm doing is I'm just urging you, asking you, when you consider this zoning regulation amendment to accommodate this jail, that you advise against it when you go to the town board. I appreciate your listening.
And what was your name, sir?
My name's Harold Smith. I am a resident of Chalkawinity.
I missed that bit of it. And I tell you, too, this is the town of Chalkawinity Planning Board. I think the best forum for this group to possibly, or any others that would like to talk or in opposition for or against a jail, would be as we did the solar farm. There's a public comment section that the town board of commissioners offers at each meeting, and I know Ms. Joy did have a sign-up sheet at the last meeting for each of the members or citizens of the community to sign up. Each were heard at that meeting. We're very cordial. A lot of good information supplied, but I think that's the best forum moving forward. I know the town board is having a meeting April the 1st, and any of you that would like to speak, by all means, that would be great. Or anytime. This board welcomes you as well. But again, the forefathers, the town board of commissioners are the ones that will inevitably make that final decision. So again, you know, having your voice heard between both boards is certainly a good spot.
Understood. My point in just saying what I said tonight was I was afraid that action was taken tonight, and I wanted the planning board to hear what we had to say.
Oh, certainly.
And it would have been a little late at that point for the planning board to have heard and to see what's happening here. So that's why I did that.
Certainly.
And I thank you for indulging.
Yeah, we certainly welcome any comment at any of the public meetings. Thank you.
Chairman, I might have 3 minutes.
Okay.
I guess that as part of the soliloquy that is that Chalkwind is near and dear to my heart. I was born in Blunt's Creek, and so the nearest town was Chalkwindity. So Chalkwindity is my hometown, and went 12 years to school here, graduated from the largest graduating class of high school ever had at 42. So that was a record, and I was part of that record. I was in the Boy Scouts here, became an Eagle Scout, Troop 48. I have a real love for this community. The thing that I wanted to pass along just as general information, and sometimes good information goes unheard. My wife is very much involved in teaching constitutional seminars. And once a year, the schools in the county will invite her to come in, and they usually do it about the third grade level. So she was fortunate enough to be able to come over and teach third grade Chalkwindity for 1 hour about the Constitution. And after the meeting, she went back and she talked to Dr. Phipps. And Dr. Phipps was telling her something that I didn't know. Chalkwindity is rated, your school right now is rated in the top 10 schools in the state of North Carolina. That is a tremendous accomplishment for a small area. And what I'm leading up to is I have a tremendous interest in economic development, obviously, in Beaufort County. I have for many years. First thing that somebody asks when they want to move into a community is, how much does the house cost? The next thing they ask is, what's your school district? You've got a tremendous attraction here. And I guess what I'm trying to lead up to is that I would suggest, for what it's worth, be careful about how you utilize the image that the town has. Perception is everything in sales. I've been in sales all my life. You've got a great community here, the nicest food line in Beaufort County, Cypress Landing next door, and those things were important, believe me. The other thing is, I was in a meeting this morning, and they were explaining what's happening in Greenville with your cancer center, what's happening in Greenville right now with your dental school, what's happening with the expansion of your heart center. That place is exploding. They're looking at which way will the town go. Right now, what they're saying is the town is pushing into Winterville. You can't tell now from Greenville to Winterville when you run out of one town into the other. Now, we all know that competition is good. And what happens when there's a demand, the price goes up. The price is going up in Winterville as they move that way. You have Highway 33 building towards you as hard as they can. You've got a four-lane road coming in Simpson. You've got that land coming on this way, which is reasonable. You've got a situation here where you've got reasonable price land and beautiful land and good facilities. In my opinion, if you as a planning board can begin to look at where is the epicenter of my development, and then sort of draw a circle out there and say, you know, where should this development go? And how's the best way for us to attract people into Chalkwindity for the next 5 years? And where are we going to go with this beautiful opportunity that we have here? I think you're going to see that you want to become a bedroom community, for lack of a better term, and certainly a residential center that can service Greenville, Washington, and anybody else who wants to come and benefit one of the top 10 schools in the state, a beautiful place to live that's not overcrowded, not heavy and crime-ridden. And the image, to me, the thing I'm really concerned about, one of the things is, pulling a jail in here is, when it is going to become a jail town. Because what they're proposing, if you look at the sitting empty in Pitt County, you got beds empty in Craven County, you got a jail in Hyde County, they can't even open up because they can't afford to open it with nobody in it, with caretakers. I mean, the boondoggles that have gone on in this stuff are really frightening when you stop and look at it. End of the story is, if you throw a jail in here now, we're facing probably about a 15% tax increase. Now, you had 4 years ago, you had a revale. My taxes went up, and I own several pieces of property. My taxes went up 30%. I nailed 15% on it for a jail. I'm up 45%. Now I want to build a school for Chocowinity. That's another 15%. It ain't going to happen. You're shooting yourself in the foot to allow this thing to come in here and take the place of what can cause Chocowinity to develop and take care of our children. And I guess I'm so passionate about it for that very reason. I just see the potential, and I don't want us to lose that potential over something that really isn't, it's not an emergency right now. You got a tier one county, middle of a recession, and no reason to have to build a jail this year or next year or the next 3 years. And so we just need to get these guys to slow down and do their homework and find out where they are and why they're doing it. Now, yet somewhere down the road, okay, we may need it, then let's find a place to put it. But you've got a piece of property out here, prime piece of property, sewer already run into it, all the makings for what you need to put a beautiful middle school. And I would love to see that there instead of an ugly federal